And there they go. Violent Point is showing good speed without that hurt, and She's Not Bluffing's on top of the action from the far outside. Oh my golly, Miss Molly races with My Girl Annie. Violent Point and Ouch That Hurt, they mix it up. They have about a length and a half on She's Not Bluffing, who's up close to the action. Nearly 3.5 or 4 lengths to My Girl Annie. About 3 lengths in front of Oh My Golly, Miss Molly, 22 1/5. Ouch That Hurt with a narrow lead from Violent Point. She's Not Bluffing, about a length and a half off, 3 deep. My Girl Annie gets pace to chase. She assumes an inside path, and here comes My Girl Annie. Boy, My Girl Annie looks like the player. 1/4 mile from the wire. She will need some racing room. And to the far outside is Oh My Golly, Miss Molly. Now My Girl Annie shifts 4 wide, and she comes with her run. In the meantime, She's Not Bluffing's up to the front. My Girl Annie's about 2 lengths off the lead. Ouch That Hurt has put away Violent Point. She's Not Bluffing's the leader in deep stretch. She's Not Bluffing continues her Cinderella season in 2021. It's her 7th career score in Roxy's Kingdom. 7 Roxy's Kingdom out of race 2. 1 Eilish make the jockey Neftali Perez. 3 Betty Boo make the jockey. And there they go. JC the Destroyer and to the inside, Betty Boom. And Betty Boom picks it up. JC the Destroyer is 2nd. Secret Gals up close. Pal Saratoga Gals 4th outside of Eilish. Here comes Megs in the 6th spot, 5 lengths from the front. 2.5 Musical Thunder, another length and a half for 2 to Starship Prankster. And Betty Boom has the lead from JC the Destroyer, a length and a half advantage at the 3/8. And Pal Saratoga Gal has 3 to find along the rail. Secret Gal's back to the 4th spot, 5 lengths from the front. Here comes Meg, now assumes the 4th spot. A little momentum through the turn, but still a lot of work to do. Starship Prankster's finding her stride, but she's a long ways from the front. I'm going to Eilish and Musical Thunder, and Betty Boom has a big lead, turning for home. Betty Boom working with 4 lengths. Pal Saratoga Gal is 2nd. Starship Prankster along the inside is making a move for 3rd. Then here comes Meg. It's Betty Boom. She needs this final 16th. Pal Saratoga Gal's trying to come and get her on the money. Here comes Pal Saratoga Gal to the outside. Perfectly timed by John Davila Jr. Pal Saratoga Gal from Betty Boom. Starship Prankster. Super 2389. $78.75. Third race starts our Wednesday jackpot pick 6. And there they go. Goldmine Kaz at the back covering Union Banks. Number 1 Dylan is flashing plenty of speed. Twisted Sunset is sent hard from his rail draw. And Twisted Sunset is the speed of the speed. Number 1 Dylan is pressing. Also up close, Where You Going, Owen? And Stone Guitar from the top shelf covering Smoke It Alone. First 5 separated by 3 lengths. Nearly 4 lengths Union Banks inside of Goldmine Kaz. They have 7 to find. 22 1/5, a good opening quarter. And Number 1 Dylan has poked his nose in front of Twisted Sunset. 3 lengths to Smoke It Alone, who gets pace to chase, and he's trying to close under a fierce drive. He covers Where You Going, Owen. Stone Guitar backpedals. Goldmine Kaz 2nd last covering Union Banks. Twisted Sunset trying to reclaim the lead inside of Number 1 Dylan. Twisted Sunset and Number 1 Dylan. Smoke It Alone's a little even paced. In 4th, Where You Going, Owen. And now Twisted Sunset has come clear in the late stages. Twisted Sunset putting away Number 1 Dylan. Smoke It Alone trying to take off for 2nd. Twisted Sunset 3 out of 4. John Davila Jr. back to back. Twisted Sunset's race we have this season. As of yesterday, Andre Worry, John Davila Jr., and Luis Perez all had 69. Perez got his. And there they go. Writer's Regret away awkwardly. He's at the back of the pack. Out for the lead is The Last Days. Keller Me Posse's up close. So too is Nutsy and Valuable Will's forwardly positioned from the outside. Fitzpatrick has the 5th position, and Writer's Regret had that awkward beginning. He's the last of 6. The Last Ace is the speed. Nutsy goes with him. So too does Invaluable Will. Color Me Posse's up close to the action, getting a nice trip. He's in behind the 3 leaders with 3 lengths to find past the 3/8. 2.5 clear of Fitzpatrick, who's closing in steadily. At the tail is Writer's Regret. In the meantime, Invaluable Will makes his move, confronting the last days. Nutsy is losing some ground. Fitzpatrick rolls into the scene with his wide charge. Color Me Posse. He's going to have to giddy up. They're in the lane. Here comes Fitzpatrick rolling up to the leaders. And Fitzpatrick comes away with the lead. And Color Me Posse's trying to take off to the far outside. But Fitzpatrick beat him to the punch. It's Fitzpatrick, a generous 3-1. Color Me Posse second, the last days third, fourth place to Invaluable Will. All right, on to the fifth race, which will start our late pick four. Start with the scratch, six Full Faith and Credit. Six Full Faith and Credit. Scratch Armando's team at 2-1. And there they go. Encryption Key hustled along to get the lead. That's his customary style, and he finds the front immediately out of the gate. Curlin's New Moon comes away in second. Beachside is third. Then we'll go to Hazam, Armando's team. Arrhythmic is second last, and at the tail is Thank You. And Encryption Key has the lead all to himself. Better than two lengths from Beachside inside of Curlin's New Moon. Hazam shares the fourth spot outside of Armando's team. Arrhythmic is second last, and he's a little less than seven lengths from the front. And he's almost six lengths in front of Thank You. It's about 13 lengths, a baker's dozen from first to last. 24 3/5, Encryption Key is uncontested. Builds up better than three lengths. Beachside is closest pursuer. Curlin's New Moon is third. Armando's team is fourth from the inside. Little less than six lengths or seven lengths off the lead. Another length to Azam with his three-wide journey. It's about six lengths to Arrhythmic, who's now picking up his stride. Still at the tail is Thank You, 48 4/5. It's all about Encryption Key. He has more than six lengths. Beachside continues to chase from second. Hazam makes a move for third. Then Armando's team, Curlin's New Moon. Arrhythmic's trying to close, so too is Thank You. Encryption Key still with the lead to himself. It is a diminishing 3.5. Here comes Beachside. Here comes Hazam. Here comes Arrhythmic. And here comes Thank You. So Encryption Key needs 3/16 for the money. Arrhythmic, one from the far outside. Thank You to the extreme outside. Armando's team's now picking up his stride. Here comes Thank You and Armando's team. Armando's team, Thank You rolls to the outside. Armando's team and Thank You. Thank You. May I have another? His 10th career score. Race 6, number 1, Killian Rose. Carlos Camillo is the new jockey. 5, Zia Adelia, new jockey, Tammy Permarini. And there they go. Banana Fanafo shows pace. Also, there is Starship Belmont from the rail. Killian Rose wants to go. Killian Rose, part of the leaders. So it's Killian Rose just in front of her, Starship Belmont. Banana Fanafo attends the pace. She's pressing 3 deep. Such a Lady is deep through the first turn, trying to get into the 4 path. Flurry of Roses is 5th, following her race's Speed Zone. Zia Adelia to her flank. Farther out is Another Smile. And Azagar is the last of 9. There is pace on up front. 24 seconds. Banana Fanafo enters the backstretch with her head in front. Starship Belmont in the 2 path. Killian Rose from the rail. Flurry of Roses is 4 lengths off the lead, striding into the 4th spot. 2 lengths clear of Such a Lady. And joining her from the outside is Speed Zone. Azagar has made up ground. She's out of last and she's advancing along the rail. The gray gets within 6 lengths up the backstretch. Zia Adelia second last. Now Such a Lady's in that spot. Tis Another Smile's at the back. 24 seconds that opening quarter of the half and 48 3. And it's Banana Fanafo with the lead at the 3/8. Better than 3. Starship Belmont is 2nd. Flurry of Roses is under a drive from 3rd. Azagar has continued her run. She's sliding into 3rd. Going to make a move for 2nd. Can she quicken and challenge Banana Fanafo in 5th races? Speed Zone. So they turn for home and it's all about Banana Fanafo. She's the one to come and catch. Azagar has sustained her run. She has a little bit of a look. And also trying to close is Flurry of Roses with Speed Zone. Banana Fanafo. Here comes Azagar. Here comes Speed Zone and Flurry of Roses. Azagar has found the front in deep stretch. Can she fend off Speed Zone and Flurry of Roses? Azagar! Azagar sustained that run all the way past the 5/8. I believe she is the
Dollar Super, $1,105. A 5-2 double, $99. 6-5-2 pick, $392.50.
Race 7 is the Dan Conway Memorial Race. Ready for the race? And there they go. Swift Start Double Vision. Look at him. He already has 2.5 on the group. Here comes the judge is second. Golany Brigade is third. In the fourth spot races Nueva York. Now, Easy Shot was away slowly. He's towards the tail of the field. Third last. Isaiah, second last. Cool Quartet is the last of all. Pretty strung out field. And Double Vision's going at a pretty good clip. 22 seconds at opening quarter. He has the lead by 2.5 lengths. Golany Brigade strides into second. He's in a good spot heading into the turn. In third, here comes the judge. Now Easy Shot's currently in the fifth spot just in front of him, Nueva York. Nueva York six off the lead, and Easy Shot is 7 lengths from the front. The other two have a ton of work to do, Cool Quartet and Isaiah. In the meantime, Golany Brigade is waiting on deck. He's ready to take over outside of Double Vision. Now can he fend off Nueva York and Easy Shot? They are both closing. Golany Brigade up to the front. Double Vision has a little fight. Nueva York up the inside. Easy Shot's rolling to the outside. Here comes Easy Shot. Easy Shot makes his move. Easy Shot above and beyond all. John Davila Jr. with 3, a training double for Chris Englehart. Goal in the- And there they go. She's So Golden is showing good speed. Miss Penelope Pitstop wants to go. Miss Penelope Pitstop outside of She's So Golden. Hope I Can vying for third with Pam Dorth Andiamo. Also there, Funny Pursuit and Miss Gold Medalist from the Top Shelf. Big break of 7 lengths to Call Me Carmelita and Late Running Modern Steel. Pace on up front. Miss Penelope Pitstop and She's So Golden. Plenty of pursuers. Hope I Can, Funny Pursuit, Pam Dorth Andiamo, Miss Gold Medalist with a wide charge, 3 lengths off the lead. Big break of 9 lengths back to Call Me Carmelita and Modern Steel. Miss Penelope Pitstop's had enough of She's So Golden. Here's Funny Pursuit. And Funny Pursuit is right alongside of the big favorite. Funny Pursuit now pokes her nose in front. Miss Penelope Pitstop tries to stay with her. Now Modern Steel is making up a lot of ground to the far outside. Can she make up the 5 lengths? On the front end, it is Funny Pursuit. Funny Pursuit, Miss Penelope Pitstop. Modern Steel is closing, but it's only for a minor placing. It's all about Funny Pursuit in the nightcap. Funny Pursuit wins by more than 3 on the line for Miss Penelope Pitstop. Modern Steel was able to manage third. 20 cents, 956 trifecta, $17.62. 2-9 late double, $19.60. 2-2-9 late pick 3, $69.37. 5 with 2 with 2 with 9, our late pick 4, $401. Wednesday pick 5 is a nice payoff, $1,700, $11.75. 5 out of 6 in our pick 6 is worth $96. Dollar Superfecta 9562, $227.75. We have a pick 6 carryover into the Thursday card. That's right. We are racing tomorrow, 110 First Post, our Thursday jackpot pick 6 carryover. Just shy of $1,500, $1,499.53. $1,499.53. Our jackpot pick 6 carry over into the Thursday card. That's it for all of the action on this Wednesday afternoon. Sure hope you had a great day of racing. First Post tomorrow, 110. When leaving the track, please drive very carefully. This has been Racing from Finger Lakes Gaming and Racetrack. Good night, everyone.